I always told myself I never would become like my father. Like, I remember growing up saying, you know, I'm never gonna drink, I'm never gonna smoke marijuana. And in my sophomore year in high school, I started doing those things. And I just remember having so much anger inside of me that I had to express it. I was very abusive, putting people down to make myself feel better. And then also, you know, physically wanting to get in fights. I knew something inside was not right. The anger started catching up with me, started cutting class, hanging out with wrong crowds. I didn't make grades to play baseball. And that's when it really began to crush my dream. And it came to the point where I was so depressed that I even thought about taking my own life. There was a recreational league that I was a part of, and I had a coach who would help me on the side. At that point, he just kept telling us about Jesus, and he would tell my father from time to time. And I remember one practice, we were on the high school field, and he began to tell my father about this guest chaplain named Donnie Moore. He was the chaplain for the Oakland A's in our area, and that he was going to be speaking at a local church. And to bring me and my brothers out, that we'd be able to meet some Oakland A's players. It's me, all my brothers, my mom, and we went there. And I remember Donnie preaching a message that was really powerful, really powerful. And I remember that day, he gave altar call. Remember my dad raising his hand. And I responded to the altar call. And he began to walk forward. And I remember that moment thinking, this God must be real. Something inside me said, you need to follow him. So I remember all me and my brothers, we began to follow him. He walked to the altar, we walked out, we walked with him. And at the altar, there was a man who embraced us. It was the first time I remember me, my brothers, and my father hugging and feeling the love like I've never felt before. It broke me. You know, when I saw my father go down to the altar, it was at that moment, you know, I began to feel the anger begin to leave. I could just tell he was a change. There was a huge change. He began to tell me he loved me. And at that time, there was a youth pastor, the same guy that had hugged me. He saw something in me that I didn't see in myself. He just began to tell me, hey, you know, you need to not do this, or, you know, this is what the Word of God says. And he would give me the Word. And then at that point, I knew there had to be a change. There's one night at youth group, a group of guys from another rival high school came to the youth group, and they wanted to fight me. And I saw the guys, and they were pointing at me, and they're calling me out and saying some choice things, and I got really angry. And just was like, you know what, I went up to the guys, I said, you know, we're not gonna fight here, this is a house of worship, but when this service is over, meet me across the park, and I am going to just, you know, I'm gonna fight all you guys, and we'll put an end to this. And so I'm on my way, walking out the doors, going across the street to fight, and all of a sudden, out of nowhere, my youth pastor comes. And he's coming out the door, he says, Matt. And I turn around and he says, you know, the Lord spoke to me that you're gonna be here. I don't know what's going on, but God told me if you go across the street to the park, you're not coming back alive. And as soon as he said that, I felt a presence come over me, like I felt at the altar. And I fell down to my knees, and it was the first time I heard God speak to me. He said, I'm sparing your life. I'm gonna use you in a mighty way. I began to see these visions. I saw me speaking in front of crowds, and I saw people getting set free and begin to see miracles and signs and wonders. And at that point, I didn't have a grid for any of that. And I remember the Lord speaking the phrase, I'm gonna make you a prophetic voice to the nations. And I remember feeling the presence of God so strong, so intense, and just begin to cry and weep. I found out weeks later that those guys were carrying guns. And they were gonna try to jump me, and there was a possibility I probably could have lost my life. That was the turning point for me. At that point, I felt a fire. I don't know how to explain, but I just felt this fire, this passion in me for God. I have a real passion to father a generation. We have a campus ministry. We've seen a need for students wanting more training and discipleship. So out of that, gave birth to a school of ministry where we're training young people in the gifts of the Spirit, how to pray for people, the character of God, the fruits of the Spirit, and really releasing them in radical evangelism. God's grace is so good. To see where God has brought me from to where I'm at now, it's overwhelming.